People, 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 people. Que pasa, sakpa, say what they do. Now the topic that has been buzzing in the news is these Jamaican men basically taking out their spouse, their girlfriend, Rete, Lele, blue, blah, bling. And I did a story maybe about 3 or 4 days ago when I said that it seemed like it is contagious, because it seems like these insecure men, it seems like these jealous men, even when they move overseas, they still take their bad attitude with them. Now, people, I was speaking specifically about an incident that occurred in the United States. I am speaking about Columbus, Ohio, to be specific, in which a Jamaican man, I am speaking about 42-year-old Gary Morris, basically take out him girlfriend, and her name is, and she is 33-year-old. I am speaking about Nerissa Distan, and I am also speaking about the daughter, who was 2-year-old. I am speaking about Serena Morris, same name as the father. Now, people, the mother of Nerissa Distan has spoken out in an interview that she did with NBC. So, people, take a listen, take a look, and then I'll give my piece.
Nerissa's mom, Andrea Comrie, says those close to her called her Denise, or Denden, in Jamaica, where they're originally from.
She would step out her circle just to make it easier and better for somebody else at all times.
She was away in Jamaica when she heard about what happened to her daughter and granddaughter.
It's just like a nightmare, like a real nightmare.
The two stayed at Comrie's house a lot. She says her daughter was trying to end their relationship with Morris, but was also worried about his well-being and wanted to support him. She says he had not been physically abusive, but was controlling.
It's just heartless for what happened. Very painful. She has such a soft heart, and that soft heart caused her heart to be taken away.
Distin was a nurse, described as a hard worker and a ball of joy.
She inspired all of us. She's a mentor for her siblings, for me, for friends, and for everybody.
Serena loved dancing. She was just starting to count, talk clearly, and sing.
Now, what is so bad about the situation is that the mother said that she was in Jamaica at the time, celebrating and enjoying Christmas and New Year's, only to get that dreaded phone call that her daughter got slapped away. And what made it even worse, she got slapped away by her boyfriend, and also him take out the little pitney. We are talking about the 2-year-old. Now, people, just imagine how that mother felt when she got that phone call. Imagine how her stomach feel. Imagine how she feel, kind of like she wants to pass away. Just imagine all the emotions and thoughts and the flashback that she had of her daughter, the good times that they spend. And people, she is gone, gone forever, R.I.P. So people, the point that I am trying to make is that that is not a good thing for anybody to experience, especially in the festive season. We are speaking about a high and then a low, point blank and period. Now, one of the reasons that I thought that this lady did this interview is because she wants to send a message, she wants to send a warning to other women out there that are also in this kind of situation, this kind of circumstance, because she said that her daughter was concerned about her life. She thought that it was imminent, she thought that the man was going to take her out. And people, sometimes some people sit in the situation and they see all the signs, they see all the red flag. However, they don't make that move. They don't make that move to secure their own life. And people, you see that it came back to haunt this lady in this circumstance, in this case. The mother also said that her daughter was supportive of the boyfriend. And people, sometimes it's good to care. However, you have to know when to say when. You have to know when to count your losses. And if you keep doing the same thing over and over and still keep getting these bad results, that means that it is time to move on. That means that you are getting all the signs. And people, if you don't secure your own life, your life will be taken away. You cannot be caught slipping, point blank and period. And the mother also made it very clear in the interview that this man was very possessive. He was obsessive. He was jealous. He was very insecure. Now, people, if you see all these signs, you can't be caught in life with your eyes wide shut. Because if you're nasty, then you're going to feel. And it can always come back and be the worst case scenario. And people, we see that in this case, it is the case. The mother also emphasized that her daughter had a very soft heart, and because she cared more about people than she cared about herself, her soft heart made her lose her heart. It made her heart stop beating. People, that is word for the wise. People, you have to take heed. People, you have to learn from the mistake of others. So people, the point is that you women out there that are in abusive relationship, I am speaking about in Jamaica, me I talk about in America, Canada, UK, Rete, Lele, Blue, Blah, Bling. Make this be a WARNING that you have to take heed. You have to take initiative. You have to make sure so you stand up for your own rights, and also most importantly for your life and the life of your partner. Because the truth and the fact is that when you are gone, you are gone. There is no reset on life, people. It is over, finito, point blank, and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up. Now, people, before I move to the next part of my video, please subscribe to my next channel. It is called Jamaica Dancehall Source. One word. Don't put no space between the words. Jamaica Dancehall Source. Now, people, the cat and mouse game between the G-A-N-G-E-S-T-E-R-S and the Popo on Mountain View continues. And what do I mean by this cat and mouse game? As the Popo running, the G-A-N-G-S-T-E-R-S them run out. Now, people, we see that they are back at it once again, one more again, because in the latest incident, we saw that a 44-year-old man, I am speaking about Lyndon Bernard, he was conned up on Mountain View Avenue. We are speaking about just in front of Exed. We are speaking about Exed Community College. People, we see that they've been going back and forth at it. And people, the latest incident that caused this thing for basically flare up once again was when there was some work given out at some construction site and there were some plywood missing. And people, that is what caused the flare up. That is what caused these G-A-N-G-S-T-E-R-S to be slapping away each other. And people, since this flare up started, there has been at least once per week. People, we are speaking about one per week for the last 2 months. Rete, lele, blue, blah, bling. So we see that these persons are back at it again for no apparent reason, no good reason. I am speaking about Jake's Road. I am speaking about Goodridge Lane. And I am also speaking about Backbooks. So people, we are speaking about three separate factions that cannot come to any amicable agreement. People, we are speaking about the darkness, and we are speaking about the ignorance, and we are speaking about the stupidity that exists in some of these garrisons. And people, this is a perfect example. So anyway, the JCF, the JDF, the PNP, and the JLP, they have come together and they've decided that this is the way to basically solve this problem, this situation. And they held a meeting at Jakes Road Community Center. And people, they are supposed to be holding a next meeting. We are speaking about at the Backbush Community Center. So people, we see that they are trying to get everybody involved. We are speaking about the residents. We are speaking about the persons that are basically doing the slap away. And it seems like they are trying to do the impossible. It seems like they are trying to defy gravity. And people, when we think about what has been going on, it seems like this is a Jamaican version of the 100-year war, because they've been going back and forth at it like cat and dog from about 1980s. And people, we are in 2020 right now, so we are speaking about in excess of about 4 decades. Now, people, if they were not able to solve this dispute in about 4 decades, do you think now that with the intervention of the JLP, the PNP, the Popo, and the JDF, they are going to just resolve it just like this? It is like waving a magic wand. People, like we say, we have to just keep hopes alive. We have to kind of hope for the best and kind of expect the worst based on what we've seen before, based on the history. And what makes this situation even worse, and why most of the persons are speaking out right now, is the fact that even a 60-year-old man basically lost his life. He picked up about 11 cars. Now people, just imagine that. We are speaking about a person that is an elderly. We are speaking about a person that is a grandfather, basically get caught up in this whole situation. People, he is not a G-A-N-G-S-T-E-R. He is not a G-U-N-M-A-N. He is just an innocent victim. Some people, we see that people are losing their life for no reason, none at all, point blank and period. So the situation in Mountain View, I am speaking about Back Road, I am speaking about Jakes Road, and I am also speaking about Goodridge Lane. We see the popo all over the place. We see the JDF all over the place. We see that they are corralling the place just to keep the peace. And we also see that a lot of the residents are moving out left, right, and center because people, it seems like there is no peace inside, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole situation as it pertains to that. And like I say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.